I'm Marc Rudov, branding advisor to CEOs and author of Be Unique or Be Ignored, The CEO's Guide to Branding. I'm here today to talk about my favorite topic, millennial mania. I don't understand it. I'll bet you don't either, but you might be participating in it. The World War II vets were our greatest generation. The millennials, the weakest generation. Truly, they are. They've been bubble wrapped since birth. They got trophies just for showing up. 30% of them are living with their parents, and each one has, on average, $30,000 in college debt. Let's take a recent example at the UCLA Law School, where a professor put a question on an exam about Ferguson, Missouri, and the riots that happened there. The students were so traumatized that the professor had to remove the question from the exam and also apologize. Seriously, how are these kids going to go into the courtrooms to argue anything that's difficult? Brown University has safe rooms for children, I'm calling them children, who are afraid of scary ideas. And what's in the safe room? Coloring books, soothing music, Play-Doh, and videos of frolicking puppies. Oh, wow, I can't wait to sell to this group. I can't wait to see these kids becoming CEOs. If this offends you, turn off this video. If you don't like facts, if you only like political correctness, don't watch me, okay? The Educational Testing Service, the company that makes the SATs, they said the American millennials have the weakest skills of all their contemporaries in the world, and they're going to hurt competitiveness. There was an article about this in Fortune magazine in February, if you don't believe me. They love social media, the millennials. They can't get enough of it. And so that's why all these corporations are doing social, social, social. You have Ginni Rometty, the CEO of IBM, always, we have to be social, social, social. All these seminars and magazine articles about you're not social enough. Well, Harvard Business Review just did a study to find out, do the social media help corporations? What was the answer? Nope. They don't help the bottom line at all. But the companies are doing it anyway. Why? Millennial mania. James Corden just took over the Late Late Show from Craig Ferguson on CBS. He had a sign-off the other night that epitomizes everything I'm saying right now. Take a look.
And don't forget to follow us on Twitter, at Late Late Show. You can like us on Facebook, heart us on Instagram, add us to your circle on Google+. You can snap us on Snapchat, link us on LinkedIn, pin us on Pinterest, swipe me right on Tinder, enter me on Grindr, kick us on Kickstarter, go fund us on GoFundMe, dig me up on Ancestry, sing me a lullaby on Bedstar, tank me on Tankster, eat me on Yelp, buy me on eBay, pick me up on Uber, lube me up on Luba, watch the movie MacGruber, squeeze me on Boober, pour me a drink on Mountain Dewster, punk me on Brewster, shovel me on Digger, insult me on Roaster, bread me on Toaster, find out what I looked like 15 years ago on MySpace, you can likey me on Likester, boink me on Binker, bookmark me on BookBook, crunch me on Chipster, troll me on Bridgester, twiddle me on Funster, throw me out on Dumpster, rub my tummy on Yumster, fight me on Worldster, send me a wish on You Wish, joke me on Laughbook, dwarf me on Tallster, tall me on Dwarfster, bazinga me on Parsons Book, torrent me on Pirate Bay, and of course, you can murder me on Craigslist.
Hey, did you hear the millennials in the audience laughing and clapping? Because they love this stuff. It makes no sense. If you can get people to your website, keep them there. Don't send them away. If you're the maitre d' in a restaurant and a patron comes into your restaurant, do you say, oh, do you know we have another restaurant across town? Why don't you leave? No. Once you have somebody, once somebody's captive, you keep him there. You don't send him away. Don't have millennial mania. Don't just follow the lifestyles of the millennials. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't add to your bottom line. And when you want customers, make sure that they're good customers. Don't care just about their numbers, but care about who they are. Fight your tendency to have millennial mania and rid it, ban it from your company. Don't forget, be unique or be ignored.